stubborn mortals. So desperate to cling to your pathetic lives. Even when there is no hope for you! Don't you ever give up!
Never. But hear this, Zanza. They will judge me not in life, but death. Both our worlds. You must succeed. Lady Mayneth.
Look starboard! What's that cloud?
You're not getting away!
Dixon!
Listen, it's over. Time for you all to return to the Bionis. Nice and quietly.
That's enough! Why, Dixon? What made you like this? Shulk looked up to you, respected you!
Dixon! Don't let Zanza control you! Wake up!
You can quit your belly aching. I'm in total control. I've always been like this. Ever since long before any of you lot were born.
Before we were born?
Now you get it. It's just like Egil said. I'm Lord Zanza's disciple. Dixon of the Trinity!
Summon copy! Mental fault! Manifest yourselves! Roaring thunder! Manifest yourselves! Summon flare! Impulse! Raging wall! Manifest yourselves! It's flowing through me! Prepare yourself! Summon force! Manifest yourself! Your fighting spirit is mine! Spear break! Water! The source of all life! Manifest yourself! My thanks! Star-searing flames of absolution! I fear I approach my limit.
Get a hold of yourself!
Ha 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 ha! You waste of space! Not so tough without Shulk, eh? Stupid beast! You should be grateful. Not everyone has a war buddy like me to lead them along. Tasted good, didn't they? The victory drinks we used to share.
I'll kill you!
What? Who was that? Show yourself!
Melia, are you all right?
Brother!
Kallion! Dixon! He works for the Bionis! He shot Shulk in the back!
Is this true? Dixon? This ends here. Your Telethia are no match for our Havres squadron. You cannot win!
Maybe you should be concentrating on your own people instead of barking at me. Looks like you've forgotten your destiny. Right, Lorathea?
Lorathea? Are you involved in this as well?
Your Highness, your naivety is quite charming, but it is also your undoing. I had much fun playing with you and your father.
What? What is this light?
Ether particles emitted so that the Bionis can be destroyed and reborn. What do you get if you cross high concentrations of ether with High Entia?
No! You wouldn't! Lorathea!
Awaken, my darling pets!
They are...
Telethia!
Brother!
Melia!
Lorathea! Let him go!
You misunderstand, child. This is the reason why High Entia are born. Do not blame poor old me.
Explain yourself!
It's just like she says. The High Entia are a race created by Lord Zanza to eliminate any annoying life forms in the preparation for the rebirth of the Bionis. Their bodies contain a gene that, when the time comes, transforms them into Telethia.
It can't be. Say it isn't so.
Melia, it is true. That is why you are our only hope.
Brother?
Whatever. We won't be needing a half-breed like you anyway. I mean, if you don't turn into a Telethia, it just means you're gonna get crushed by one. That's the only thing you're good for. Rise up, pet. Do my bidding. Kill your lovely sister.
Brother! Just hold on! I'll find a way to save you!
Melia! So sorry! I always placed such a heavy burden on you!
Don't say such things, brother!
But at least I can still shoulder the destiny of our people. The burden meant for you
brings a tear to my eye.
These moments are to be treasured.
How?
Brother!
Melia! Father's wish
and the future of the High Entia are in your hands. Yours and Shulk's.
Telethia, destroy him! Dixon!
I got it. Too late? Damn him!
Oh. So I'm... What was I doing? What was the purpose of my life? Got it wrong. I was never alive. It was Xanza. All along, everything I did was...
Do you want to say pointless?
That voice.
Nobody else can decide that. Only you.
Shulk. Here. Mikal made you a wonderful new weapon. Since you lost your Monado, I mean. It uses the latest Machina technology. Use it when you wake up. Then, let's all go on living.
We've relocated the High Entia and the Nopon refugees to Colony 6. Thankfully, the Mechon did us a favor by fortifying it for us. It should hold out for a while.
It's ironic. We want to escape Xanza, but we can't leave his body, the Bionis.
Well, this is our home.
Princess, I have to know. Should we be worried about the evacuated High Entia?
I cannot be sure, but I believe not. All those who survived are part Homs like me.
Understood.
If they ever do transform, I will be among them. If that time comes, you know what to do.
Are you sure?
Everyone is obliged to accept their fate.
No way! There's no way Kallion would leave the fate of the High Entia to you if that was going to happen.
Precisely. And Melia, if we are to survive, we must fight Xanza and the Telethia. It may not be the case with all of them, but a large number of Telethia were once High Entia. Your subjects and your brethren.
I am prepared for that, even if it means harming my brethren. It is for the protection of the survivors. That is the final wish of my father and brother. I will fight to free the soul stolen by Xanza.
You're a fighter, Melia. We will need all your strength in the fight ahead. How's Shulk?
He's going to make it. His wound has closed. I think Maenith used the last of her power to protect him.
So he's okay?
Linarda is tending to him now. Fiora?
He won't wake up. It's like his consciousness has sunk to the bottom of a cold, dark lake. I keep saying his name, but he doesn't respond.
Sansa's gonna pay for this.
What if the Telethia attack?
Then we'll have to fight without Shulk. That's why we've strengthened our defenses.
That weapon I made should come in handy as well.
We're backed into a corner, but we'll give it all we've got.
Can your resistance truly achieve anything?
What do you mean by that, Alvis?
Exactly what I said. We were all born of the Bionis, of Xanza. It is Xanza's will that the Telethia return us to the body from whence we came. Whether we die of old age or in battle, we all eventually return to the Bionis. We cannot escape this fate. Am I wrong?
You've got it backwards, man. Just because he thinks it doesn't make it so. We decide whether to keep living or not.
I agree. Even though he's our creator, that doesn't afford him the right to take our lives on a whim.
But that is the thinking of a Homs. He is a god. Such morals cannot apply to gods.
So you think we should just shut up and die?
If that is the fate decided by a god.
You are mistaken if you think we will simply accept such a fate and wait to die.
We'll never stop fighting, not till the end.
To Xanza, the outcome is the same. Thus, your logic is flawed.
It ain't the outcome that's important. It's the will to fight back.
Even if you die in vain.
Alvis! Whose side are you on? You scared or something? Frightened of a few Telethia?
Stop this. There's no point fighting amongst ourselves.
Fiora.
Sorry. I need to go and get some air.
Fiora, are you all right?
Guess I wasn't hiding it well. I didn't want to worry anyone.
It must be difficult living with that body.
I'm getting more and more used to it. But people still look at me funny. Oh, it's not that bad. It feels pretty comfortable, actually. I don't need to worry about food or anything like that.
I see.
This body... The energy from the chest component made it work. It turned out to be a Monado. Such a strange feeling.
A Monado? Was that the Monado that Xanza took from Maenith? Will your body cease to function?
I'll be fine for now. There's still some stored energy left.
But then what?
Oh. Melia, if I ever... Please take care of Shulk.
Don't talk like that. How can you ask me such a thing?
I'm sorry.
There's no need to apologize.
You're right. Thank you, Melia.
If Shulk awakes, will you tell him?
No. He worries too much anyway.
He does worry. It's just like him.
Actually, I'm already dead. I have been since the Mechon attacked.
Fiora.
But I'm happy now. This body has given me the chance to live. Maybe I don't have much time left, but at least I can be with Shulk for a little while longer.
Do you feel that strongly for him?
Yes. That's why I'll fight on and help him in any way I can. Let's get back. Everyone will start worrying.
Yes. You are right.
And Melia, can you keep it secret from the others?
You do not want them to worry. I admire your strength.
Maybe I'll tell him. But only when the time is right.
I won't say a word. I'm nothing compared to her.
A siren!
Fiora, let's hurry back!
Okay.